And now for something completely different.
Forget everything you've been told by others before. Get ready for the real deal. The full story. The whole enchilada. It's the Lance Roberts Show. Presented by Clarity Financial. It's life, money, and sweat equity. Now, welcome in to the Lance Roberts Show.
And welcome to the show. It is 3 o'clock right here at The Real Investment Advice, where we host the show today. You're listening to Lance Roberts Podcast. Glad you could join us as always. Markets are closing up today. Nice bounce today, up about 15 points here at the close. And of course, as always, don't go quickly look at the markets. We're still settling out here for a few minutes. But overall, nice move today in the markets. Really kind of on the back of the comments yesterday coming out of the White House that, well, there may be a deal done coming up potentially with China on trade talks. However, despite that, earlier this morning, Trump comes out and says, hey, I'm not in any pressure to do anything with China. But yet, stocks, after having been oversold here recently, we pulled back to support. We talked about this at length yesterday and had talked about this bounce that was continuing to come. Not surprising, we had to follow through day to day exactly as expected. And again, we had been adding exposure to portfolios earlier this week. The follow through today, very nice. We do have some specific stocks to talk about today in particular that were really kind of moving in the markets. But overall, really, we just kind of continue this process of coming down to this recent support, which was the previous peaks of the market back in January, and then bouncing up here. I do want to direct your attention to one thing, though, in particular here, because it is a little bit interesting as to how the markets are playing out here currently. I want you to notice in particular that the markets gapped up today, and we had a nice little opening gap up from the recent bottom that we had. And again, you know, we bottomed right here along the previous peaks when we'd broken out above the markets. You'll notice that also when we broke out above the January highs, we also gapped at that open as we moved up that day, as kind of that exuberance came into the markets. And what you'll notice is that we got about 3 days worth of advance in the markets before the market kind of peaked, sold off, came back down to support, and then rallied again. Today, another gap up open. Now, why do I bring this up? You know, gaps are typically very bullish, but they also show really kind of one other issue. Importantly, if we go back here and look at every time the markets gapped open, we gapped up in back in early June, and the markets had a rally for a couple of days. And did okay. If you go all the way back to really even earlier than that, we saw another gap up in earlier in June. And same thing here. We had a brief rally before the market kind of petered out. So, and this pattern really kind of runs all the way back to the beginning of this year. These gaps have been kind of an exciting moments for the markets, but it also uses up a lot of the, well, the fuel that is put into place by these overbought, oversold conditions. We talked about this yesterday in particular, looking at the daily chart, is that now, see, we're all the way back here, almost with this gap up today, we are almost all the way back to being overbought after being oversold earlier this week, which allowed this kind of impetus of the market to come back up. We've now used most of that fuel. So it doesn't mean that we can't go higher here. And again, as we talked about on Tuesday in our Technically Speaking post, we said, hey, look, this market has a real shot at getting back up to about 3,000 on the S&P. And that's still very much a target. I think there's a real possibility here that we break out of these recent highs. Everybody will get excited. We set all-time highs again. But again, we're using up a lot of that fuel here, really not going much of anywhere really since the beginning, end of August. So over the last couple of weeks, we haven't really done much, but the markets are recovering here. But importantly, though, and from a bullish standpoint, now, I don't want you to miss this point. We are consolidating at new highs. We are basically broke out to new highs from earlier this year. We've been consolidating that pattern. A move up to new highs from here is definitely a continuation of the bullish pattern. There's absolutely no denying that. That's why we increased exposure to portfolios and have recommended you do the same over the last couple of weeks in our newsletter. Watch that breakout here, because if that occurs again, that's going to suggest that the momentum behind the market is definitely there. And of course, that's going to continue on. And again, as we talked about as well, we're moving into that seasonally strong period of the year where October, November, December, you're going to start to see portfolio managers needing to play catch up with performance for the year. That typically gives some further support to the markets. Now, remember, this is all short-term stuff. Next month, next quarter, and this is one of the mistakes that investors make on a regular basis, is they mistake short-term movements in the market for long-term outcomes. Remember that what happens in the short term is pure psychology, and that psychology is represented really by price movement of the market. What the market's doing from one day to the next is really just a reflection of what the herd of investors are doing in the markets. Longer term, it's all about fundamentals. And in the longer term, we talk about fundamentals and valuations. We talk about economic growth. And when you've got economic growth chugging along at 2.25%, you're not going to be able to support valuations at 31, 32, 33 times earnings for an extended period of time. Lower growth rates, lower rates of inflation actually drag valuations down over time. So again, longer term out, a continued advance in the markets can become much more problematic. But in the short term, again, psychology right now, very bullish. The uptrend, as you can see here quite clearly in our chart on our screen, if you're watching our live stream right now at our live stream feed or on our Facebook page, you can actually watch the live stream, but you can see the chart here. I mean, this bullish uptrend is very clear, so that's why we want to maintain exposure. We've been increasing exposure back since early March, early April, continue to do so. Now, let's talk about some specific stocks that were actually kind of moving around the markets today. Over the last couple of days in particular, two of the kind of the big shockers have been KLA Tencor and Micron Technologies. Both of them broke down after KLA Tencor had made some comments at a conference talking about weaker DRAM and memory prices going into the end of the year. On the back of that, we had a sharp sell-off in tech stock and semiconductor stocks, really kind of across the board, but primarily we saw it show up in KLA Tencor as well as Micron. Both of these stocks that we wrote about on our rapro.net website, we said that both of these were basically flirting with stop-loss points and important support that had gone back to even earlier this year. Fortunately, today we saw a bit of a bounce here. Stocks are trying to maintain that support. Now, it's not uncommon for these stocks in particular to have big swings, because we've actually seen this multiple times with this stock over the course of the last couple of years. As you can see here, we've had multiple bottoms right here. So there's a lot of support built up for KLA Tencor right around $100 a share. Bouncing off that support today, you want to give this a little bit of room. Keep your stops in at about $100 a share on KLA Tencor. Micron got a nice upgrade from Tepper today, who runs Appaloosa Holdings. He says he really likes the stocks longer term, likes Micron in particular. Micron had a nice bounce today, also coming off important support right around $40 a share. So make sure you keep your stops in place on these two stocks, but they are representative of the broader technology sector. That sector has gotten very oversold, and there is some really good value. If you take a look at the fundamentals of Micron and KLA Tencor in particular, their fundamentals are cheap, really cheap. The income is good, sales are great, and price to earnings valuations are below 10. So you're looking at companies that truly have some fundamental value here, have had a big contraction. So there's an actual tradable opportunity here as long as you maintain very tight stops from where you are now. Another big disaster today was Kroger's, who we have talked about here before in the past. We like the stock. One thing in particular with Kroger's is they've been going through kind of a turnaround, this whole Amazon issue.
Amazonization?
Exactly. That's the word I was looking for. It's a new word. We're going to put it in the dictionary. So, but yeah, you know, the whole threat of Amazon on the grocery store business weighed on the stock earlier this year. It's had a very nice recovery, rallied up to new highs. A little bit of drag in their earnings. Now, say they did beat earnings and they did beat estimates, but they've been going through some restructuring of their stores to compete with this whole Amazon effect thing. It's something that will probably pay off longer term. The stock had a big drop today. Too early to try to buy it here, but as long as Kroger's can kind of hold support between this $28 and $30 a share level and kind of base there, probably some opportunities for the stock. Fundamentally, the company looks good longer term. Outside of that, J.P. Morgan also announced today, again, bank stocks have not performed all that well today this year, despite the fact that net interest income is coming up because of the Fed raising interest rates. J.P. Morgan really hasn't done all that well. They did announce today that earnings this year are going to be lighter than really kind of what than what's been expected. Stock's still performing okay here, but it's been under pressures of late. We really kind of see that across the board in a lot of these financial stocks in particular. Again, doesn't make a lot of sense. Take a look at a lot of the money center banks, JP Morgan, Bank of America. Take a look at some of the big financial companies like Goldman Sachs. Really, performance has been pretty horrid in the financial sector. And even if we look over at the financial sector itself, performance really hasn't been all that great this year. So again, it's kind of interesting. With interest rates rising, you should see their net interest margins coming up. Profitability should be good. You should be seeing some better performance in the financial sector. Just not really seeing it much there at all. One area that we continue to watch closely, because it tells us a lot about what's kind of happening with the world as a whole, is keep a watch on bonds, because despite the fact that the world keeps talking about stronger economic growth, higher wages, etc., we should be seeing interest rates really starting to move up. But again, we've been trapped between this range on interest rates between about 2.8 and 3%. Bonds bounced today again as well, coming off that 3% level, seeing that pullback here a bit, bond prices going up. But again, I think the longer term economic story here is that interest rates can't move up much without really severely impacting the economy. And so when we get to the next recession, probably in 2019, the latest 2020, we're going to see interest rates most likely on the 10-year treasury somewhere south of 1%. When that happens, you're going to have a very nice net return in owning bonds and portfolios, which still act as a very important diversifier for portfolios and managing risk. Take a quick break. We're going to come back. I got a couple of stories to get into. We will talk about the next financial crisis, because it's been the story this week, because we're 10 years post Lehman. And a lot of belief is that we'll never have a financial crisis again. We'll talk about the probability of that when we come back from the break. I'm your host, Lance Roberts. You're listening to Lance Roberts Podcast right here at realinvestmentadvice.com. Thanks for joining us. Be right back. Definitely don't go away.
Get daily investment news you can use, delivered at the speed of the internet. Sign up for Lance's newsletter now at lanceroberts.com.